I've recently moved to a new neighborhood here in Dubai. So after all the unpacking, now's the time to explore the neighborhood, find local resources, find nearby Mandi restaurants. I've been in Dubai for 8 years, and it's not the first time that I moved. And personally, being away from home, living and working abroad, it taught me how to easily adapt and adjust. But right now I feel weird. Even though I moved into a new place, I still have this stagnant feeling that nothing has changed. I feel like most of things have become routine and lacked their purpose. No matter what I'm doing, it feels like I'm accomplishing nothing. I feel stuck. Feeling stuck in life can mean many things to many different people. It can wear different guises. But I believe one thing for sure. Feeling stuck is a sign something needs to change in your life. I know that I'm not alone. It's a universal human experience to feel stuck at some point. Life can get complicated at times, especially when we're juggling multiple roles and overwhelming responsibilities. Burnout. Maybe your finances have taken a hit, and everything in between. It's a tough position to be in. I really want to move on from this phase, so I allowed myself to share and be vulnerable with people I trust. Sometimes keeping things bottled can be unhealthy. Opening up can be a great way to release all the tension that has been building for so long. I received some advice and I realized it's true that the more we feed a thought, the stronger it becomes. I've been telling myself over and over again that I'm stuck. These negative thoughts just come in without knowing it. They just hold you back until you start to feel hopeless, helpless, and powerless. These negative thoughts drag you away and trap you. Identifying the root cause of your feelings could be an effective way to recover. How you are feeling right now is valid. It's normal. But also remember, you won't always feel this way because eventually things can get better. And there are many different things you can do that will help. There's no overnight cure, of course. Getting unstuck in life involves some work. I've personally tried these steps and they work for me. Reconnect to your why. Losing your why is kind of like your favorite shirt has gone missing, but somewhere you know it's there inside your room. You simply can't locate it because of so many clutters. Our why is our purpose. And most of the time, if you feel stuck, we often lose sight of the bigger picture. Like in my case, I need to remind myself why I chose to live abroad and become an overseas Filipino worker. I need to revisit my intention, why I started this YouTube channel. Our why is our daily reminder to move forward, especially when everything we believe in is challenged. So it's always important to revisit and reconnect with your why. Move your body. This is Al Barsha Pond Park, and it's very near to my new home. Best place for those who love to go for a long walk. It has well-laid tracks for jogging and cycling. It has bike rentals and fitness machines. So it's perfect for both families and fitness enthusiasts. It also has a huge central pond. For me personally, being outside and in nature, it does wonders for my well-being. But there are times when getting out of bed in the morning may feel overwhelming. Those days when you just want to hide out in bed rather than face the world. But if you want to help yourself to heal, I encourage you to start small and choose to move. Exercise and movement can boost positive mood and energy. So if you feel like it, go for a walk and take a time out to soak up a little sunshine. Take responsibility. When we feel stuck in life, there's a tendency we see ourselves as the victim and we fall into the blame game. We blame others to escape from guilt or because we're struggling to understand our own emotions. Blaming others can have long-term consequences on your personal growth and relationships. Remember that when you avoid admitting you were wrong, you don't grow. So start taking responsibility for your life and never put your life fully in the hands of other people. Stay away from a victimized mentality and stop focusing on other people's mistakes. Practice being hopeful. Hope is the ability to see the positivity in life. I admire those people who can constantly see the bright side of life in difficult times. Some people are just naturally optimistic, and I would love to learn that. I admit that when I'm caught up with the roller coaster of life, I can't stop myself from being pessimistic, so I always end up feeling lost. I don't know what to do or what to feel or which direction to go. And I know this is something I must work to change. So right now, I am practicing these three steps: pause, breathe, reflect. I believe these steps can help me regain the spirit of hope when things or situations are spinning out of control. Stop comparing yourself to others. When you're single as an adult, people start to ask, why are you still single? Or when will you get married? I think the truth about what makes us uncomfortable with the idea of being single is comparison. My friends are married or in a relationship. Why others seem to be doing good in this area? And why I'm not? Another instance is when we don't know how to handle career envy. The feeling can be toxic. Inevitably, we compare ourselves to those whose career paths are parallel to ours. Like in my case, I work as a full-time finance administrator in an advertising agency, and at the same time, I'm running this channel as a content creator. I'm grateful to have these two amazing jobs. However, at times I compare myself to other content creators, why they seem to really excel in this field. Why they have more subscribers or views and all that. So again, comparison. And it's hard to be on social media and not compare yourself to others. But I want to stop beating myself up because I'm totally aware that comparison is a thief of joy. It's a fast track to unhappiness. It leaves me feeling not so great about myself. So what I'm doing right now is I shift this comparison as motivation, as an inspiration. I try to train my mind to step away from unfavorable comparisons. Like in social media, we see other people's best moments highlighted in reels without seeing their real life struggles. No one truly knows what's happening behind the scenes. And when we compare ourselves to others, it leaves us often feeling frustrated and paralyzed to move forward. So I know it's easier said than done, but let's break the comparison cycle. And remember, the only person you should be comparing yourself to is yourself. Focus on growing from within. Create space. I love decluttering. Personally, decluttering for me is very therapeutic. What I am starting to incorporate right now in my life is to declutter not only my home, but also declutter the things in my life that are no longer serving me. So I learned that clutter is classified into two categories, physical and mental. Physical means persons, places, or things. Mental, on the other hand, are your thoughts, beliefs, and habits. Everything we do, our thoughts, our dreams, our health, our relationships, even this good stuff, takes up space. Sometimes it feels too much. So this method called creating space will allow us to live our life in a simple way, and at the same time, will also allow us to create more room to enjoy life. Creating space may include removing things or staying away from people that drain your energy. Create space by saying no. Whether you're at home or at work, knowing how to say no can help you prioritize your needs. It's one of the most loving things you can do for yourself. Creating space may also include social media or digital detox. Create space by pampering yourself in simple pleasures. Create space by choosing self-love. Take action. It's hard to be motivated when you feel like you can't move. I know it's not easy, but the safest way to begin to get unstuck is to make a commitment to move, to act. You can make progress if you start to take action. You can break them down into smaller steps. I break my goals into smaller, attainable steps. I reward myself and celebrate small wins. Feeling stuck is one of the darkest periods of my life, but I'm happy to say I learned more about myself during this season. I've learned that life isn't always about achieving or acquiring things, but sometimes it is about letting go, letting things be. So consider your experience of feeling stuck or trapped as an opportunity, a blessing to a better way of life. Thank you for watching Tisa Diaries, and I'll see you in the next video. As always, stay happy, healthy, and blessed.